Weathering refers to the natural processes of disintegration and decomposition of rocks. It includes breaking down of rocks, soils and minerals through contact with water, biological organisms and atmospheric gases. So, the process of weathering is triggered with the change of environmental conditions. For example, when a part of the land is uplifted, the rocks are exposed to a different kind of environmental setup. As a result of this change, the rocks may be disintegrated, fragmented or decomposed to survive in the new conditions to which they have been exposed. Weathering is one of the major processes in the rock cycle, and it is the first step in flattening the mountains that have been uplifted by endogenic processes. It shapes the Earth's surface topography or configuration and alters rock materials, converting them into sediments and soils. In this video, we are going to look at the three types of weathering and their causes. The first one is physical weathering, which occurs when there are physical changes to the landforms, rocks or soil. While the rocks might seem pretty solid to us, it is actually full of tiny cracks and crevices. Water fills up these cracks and crevices and expands and contracts with changes in temperature. When this happens over and over again, those cracks get larger and larger until they eventually cause pieces of the rock to break off. So, in this process, the rocks are broken down by physical forces such as wind, water, and temperature fluctuations. This process is also known as mechanical weathering. Do remember that in case of physical weathering, there is no change in the chemical composition of the rocks at the molecular level. Next is the chemical weathering. This type of weathering occurs when the minerals in the rocks react with air and water. In these chemical reactions, some minerals dissolve while others combine with water and atmospheric components such as oxygen and carbon dioxide to form new minerals. Let us assume that there is a hill that has significant amounts of iron ore. If other factors expose that iron ore, a chemical reaction can occur between the iron and air, creating rust. Iron may be a very solid material, but rust can be easily pushed away by water and air, leaving space where there was once solid iron or rock. This process is called oxidation, and it is a type of chemical weathering. So simply remember that chemical weathering involves breaking down rocks through some sort of chemical reaction. Finally, there is biological weathering, which is weathering caused by a living organism. This involves breaking down of rocks with the help of living things like plants or animals. For example, tree roots growing through cracks in rocks can eventually make the rocks break apart. There are also organisms called lichens that can release acids into rocks and cause them to soften and break down. Remember, weathering does not remove the entire rocks or landform. So man-made processes like mining and quarrying is not an example of biological weathering. This is all about types of weathering.